What happened? A KCRA 3 investigation is uncovering some unsettling questions about the response to the deadliest firefighting accident in years. Our exclusive KCRA 3 investigation is raising some new questions about how the Forest Service responded to the deadliest helicopter crash in years.
New documents obtained by KCRA 3 appear to paint a picture of confusion and miscommunication in the hours following the crash. KCRA 3's Mike DeSalle joins us now from our newsroom with the details. Mike?
And JVD, these are the documents obtained by KCRA 3 that are raising those new questions about what the Forest Service knew, when they knew it, and did fire bosses do enough to pass along that information to other emergency crews? The Forest Service defends their actions, but does acknowledge there's an investigation underway right now asking those very questions. This is a U.S. Forest Service dispatch log obtained exclusively by KCRA 3. This log, coupled with these new pictures of the fiery crash site, sparking new questions. Trinity County Supervisor and retired Forest Service member Roger Jagel saying,
"It's very concerning to the, you know, sheriff and the people responsible for public safety." And
the reason for concern is the accuracy and lack of information passed on about this crash, not only to emergency responders, but also to the public.
Was there at any point in time an intentional decision made to withhold information from the public?
No.
Look at the timeline for yourself. At 7:41 p.m., this crash is reported. By 8:30, four people are confirmed injured. By 9:21, the flight manifest noted in the dispatch logs confirms there were 12 people on board that helicopter. But according to published reports, the Sheriff's Department is not notified of possible missing victims until 5 hours after this crash. Furthermore, 8 hours later, at 3:22 in the morning, when the Sheriff's Department asks if there are 9 people still missing, dispatchers respond, quote, "We told them as far as we knew, there was no one else on the helicopter." Nearly 18 hours after this crash, in a face-to-face interview with KCRA 3, the Forest Service publicly still appeared not to know the extent of this tragedy.
Do you know how many people were on board the helicopter when it crashed?
That information is still unclear at this point in time.
Adding even more questions is that as the Forest Service was saying that to us, it was also notifying the NTSB that there are confirmed fatalities, those inconsistencies leading some to question, others to defend the Forest Service.
It's not uncommon in an emergency situation that a number of different versions will come out before we get it settled down, everybody settled down, and figuring out, okay, what really did go on here.
I think there was a delay in information, the information sharing, you know, for whatever reason.
Now, when I asked Forest Service spokesperson Kent Romney why there was some confusion over the number of people on board that helicopter and why some of the information was delayed getting to the public, he told me, quote, "That is an excellent question. I honestly don't know why." He says, of course, the formal investigation will continue and that, quote, "lessons will be learned from this incident." But he adds, even had they been able to get accurate information immediately from this scene, it likely would not have saved any more lives. Live in the newsroom, I'm Mike DeSalle. Dave,
all right,
back
Mike,
to you.
Thank you. And this story, as you might imagine, is gaining a lot of interest. And on KCRA.com, we have a copy of the transcripts at the center of these questions, plus a slideshow with pictures from the crash site. Just click on the top stories section of the front page.